हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ नेटवर्क लेयर एंड प्रोटोकॉल्स ऑफ एडवांस कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क एंड विच इज़ अ सब्जेक्ट इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर फॉर CUNIF ब्रांच। एंड लेट मी टेल यू, द फर्स्ट चैप्टर विल कंप्राइज ऑफ टू वीडियोस, सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट वीडियो फॉर द सेम। आफ्टर दिस वीडियो द लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज़ नेटवर्क लेयर एंड इट्स ड्यूटीज, IP एड्रेस विद द नोटेशंस, डिफरेंट प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड डिबगिंग टूल्स। नाउ इफ यू रिमेंबर OSI 7-layer model, PDNTSPA, starts with physical layer, data link layer, network, transport, session, presentation, application, right? So network layer is responsible for sending the packet from the source all the way to the destination. So if you could imagine your phones not having network, so you cannot receive or give a call, right? Network layer is the lowest layer that deals with end-to-end transmission, fine. And any layer has two functions: it takes services and it provides services. So network layer is preceded by data link layer and succeeded by transport layer. So network layer provides services to transport layer and network layer takes services from data link layer. These are some of the network layer duties. The details can be seen here. Now what is internetworking? Internetworking is connection of different types of networks. For example, with my Wi-Fi, which is a private network, that should be connected to an internet, which is a public network. So private and public, two different networks, connection for the same is known as internetworking, that is done by network layer. Addressing, as we hear the name addressing, IPv4 address comes in mind, IPv6 address comes in mind, which is a numerical label assigned to each device connected to an internet. That is done by network layer. Routing, as the name implies, it is all about optimal path. As you can see, Google Maps, right? Google Maps provides us the most efficient path where the travel time will be less. Here also, routing deals with optimal, most efficient path. That is the task of network layer. Data is sent in the form of packets. Packets can be encapsulated, can be decapsulated, that is nothing but packetizing. Finally, we need to send the packet, but the packets quite be huge and the channel through which it should be sent is small. So those packets must be divided and that is known as fragmentation. That is done with the help of network layer. Excuse me. Coming to IP addressing, it is a numerical label assigned to each device connected to a computer network that uses IP for communication. It must be a unique address. There should be no same address of two devices or more devices connected to the same network. IP address serves two functions. It provides host ID, it provides network ID. Now what is a host and what is a network? For example, in a lab, if there are 20 PCs connected to a LAN network, then the first PC is host 1, second PC is host 2, and the whole LAN network comes under network ID. I hope it is clear. The second purpose served by IP address is location addressing. That is, host 1 is present in Mumbai, host 2 is present in again Mumbai. So location addressing, that is MAC address. These are tasks provided by IP addressing. Coming to IPv4 address, it is a 32-bit address and it must be unique. Now what is address space? How much number of addresses could be assigned via IPv4? The formula for the same is 2 raised to n. N is number of bits. For IPv4, n is 32. So 2 raised to 32, roughly 4.2 billion addresses could be assigned as far as IPv4 address is concerned. But in the whole world, we are something around 7.5 billion. So IPv4 addresses have shortcomings. We have less number of IPv4 addresses, right? Coming to representation of IPv4 address, there are three ways to represent an IPv4 address. First way is binary notation. You could see the example. It is of 32 bits. The second is dotted decimal notation. Binary can be converted to decimal. I hope you have gained the appropriate skill by using or going through detailed techniques, right? Which is the most preferred one? Dotted decimal notation. And finally, hexadecimal notation, which starts from 0 to 9 and A to F, if you remember hexadecimal digits. And each hexadecimal digit is equivalent to 4 bits. But IPv4 address is of 32 bit. So 8 bit, or I can say 8 digit hexadecimal IPv4 address will be there. I hope it is clear. In case of any doubts, you could post a comment and I can surely help you out. IPv4 address format consists of two parts, network ID and host ID. I have already discussed that. As far as addressing is concerned, there are two ways or two addresses, classful and classless. Firstly is classful, which is classified into five aspects, class A to class E. For digital format, class A starts from 0 and ends with 127. For binary format, class A starts with 0 and so on. So if you could see this address, this binary address, it is starting with 0. So obviously this is a class A address. Dotted decimal is starting with 145. So 145 wala address will be class B network, because 145 comes in between 128 to 191. I hope it is clear how to identify an IP address with their classes. So this is the five formats. So class A designation is 0, class B is 10, and so on, which we have already seen in the previous slide. For class A network ID, we have 7 bits reserved for it. For host ID, we have 24 bits reserved for it, right? For class B, we have 14 bits reserved for network ID and 16 bits for host ID, and it is denoted by 10. So if you calculate it, class A 7 plus 24 becomes 31, and the remaining 1 bit is for 0. For class B, 14 plus 16 is 30, and the remaining 2 bits are 10, and so on. Class A, B, and C are unicast addresses. That is, it follows unicasting, that is one to one, one sender to one receiver. But this drawback is being managed by class D, which is multicasting. That is nothing but one to many. And class E is reserved for future use. As we have seen class full, now we'll focus on classless addressing. Classless addressing has three major restrictions. The first restriction is address in a block must be contiguous. In this example, if the first address is ending with 32, the second address should be 33, the third address should be 34, and so on. I hope the first restriction is clear. Second restriction says number of address in a block must be in a power of 2. Now in this block, in the given example, we have 16 addresses in a block which is starting with 32 and ending with 47. So if you can count, it gives us 16 addresses. Is 16 a power of 2? Yes, 2 raised to 4 is 16. So what I am trying to convey is, in a block there could be 2 raised to 0, that is one address. There could be 2 raised to 1 equal to 2, that is 2 addresses. 2 raised to 3 equal to 8, that is 8 addresses in a block. I hope the second restriction is also clear. The first address must be evenly divisible by the number of addresses. This is the third restriction. What they are trying to convey is, the first address ends here with 32. The number of address in this block is 16, so 32 divided by 16. Is it evenly divisible? Yes, it is evenly divisible. Finally, coming to the last part of this video, and if you remember, this whole chapter will comprise of two videos. This is the first video, right? So network address translation, it converts a private IP address to public and public IP address to private. Now if we focus on this diagram, the private IP addresses like 192.168.0.101, 102, 103, the three workstations, those are private IP addresses. It is connected to a switch. Switch is an intra-networking device. Intra-networking device is nothing but the devices that are connected to a similar network. So these three devices are connected to a similar network. Fine, so this is a private network. But once the packet moves from switch to internet, it becomes public network. It becomes public network because internet is a public space. Now router is an internetworking device. Internet is a public network, switch is a private network. So public and private is connected via router, so it is an internetworking device. So when the packet moves from right to left, So it changes from private to public IP address. When the packet moves from left to right, so it becomes or it transforms public IP address to private IP address. I hope the data is clear. Fine. Next. As you remember, we have only 4.2 billion addresses for IPv4 and we are 7.5 billion. So we are in shortage of IPv4 addresses. So this problem is partially solved by NET. Now, how does it solve the so-called problem? These workstations have three different IP addresses, but the router gets to know only the default gateway 192.168.0.1. So for router, these three different stations has only one address. So for this router, as far as this router is concerned, these three devices share a similar address of default gateway. So if these three devices are using a same address, so partially it solves our shortage of IPv4 addresses. I hope the point is clear. For example, PC1 wants to know what is the temperature of Mumbai. So it sends a packet via switch, via router to the internet. Now internet wants to return the data of Mumbai climate to router. Now router has only one information, 192.168.0.1, which default gateway is shared by all the devices. How router gives that particular data of Mumbai climate to first PC? For that purpose, we have NET mapping table. So for each private IP address, you can see there is a public IP address. So this NET mapping table is used by router to properly send the data to a proper device. I hope this point is clear, right? So some advantages and disadvantages of NET. NET solves overlapping issues by NET mapping table. NET hides internal IP structure from external world. Obviously, the private IP address of the first PC is hidden by switch to router, because router gets only default gateway information. So I hope it is clear. Disadvantage is it hides actual end device. By hiding actual end device, that is the correct private IP address, it needs to focus on NET mapping table, which increases the delay. So this is how some disadvantages of NET is discussed. So we have come to the end of first chapter, part 1. Soon I'll upload part 2 of the first chapter. Keep posting your doubts. I'll surely help you. Thank you. Take care.